Welcome to Logos Bible Software. In this video, I'll help you start using Logos confidently by walking you through a basic passage study. While Logos can scale with your needs to very advanced use cases, let me begin by showing you around and highlighting a few study tools. The key to navigating Logos is the main toolbar. All of Logos's tools and features can be accessed from the toolbar, including your library, the search tool, and your top Bible. Let's take a look at a few that will allow you to focus on a passage while learning Logos on the side. By the way, I have the Logos Max subscription, so your experience may look a little different depending on your subscription level and library. When Logos first opens, you'll be greeted by the dashboard, which contains helpful guides and links to help you learn and explore Logos, including the Get Started Wizard, which is one of the easiest ways to jump into a rich study. I'll start by inputting my passage, Mark 4:35 to 41. As you read Mark's account of Jesus calming the storm, your study Bible and commentary will scroll along with you to keep you in sync. Take a few moments to read the passage and your open study Bible and commentary. When you find a helpful insight, left-click and drag to show the selection menu. This menu gives you quick access to some key actions like copying your selection, taking a note, and more. Notes created from the selection menu are anchored to the text, meaning that the note links back to the text you selected, and the book now shows a note icon pointing you to your note. The selection menu can also help you study original language terms, even if you don't know Hebrew or Greek. Here, the disciples say Jesus isn't concerned about them. I'll select that word and choose Study, which runs the Bible Word Study Guide. The guide shows various details, like related original language words and the senses of the word. Click on a translation, and the graph expands to show example verses. In our case, the verse in our passage, as well as several other instances in the New Testament. These other examples bring rich color to the scene in the boat. The disciples are accusing Jesus of indifference, like the hired hand in John 10, or of intentionally ignoring their needs, like Galileo with the beating of Sosthenes. You'll often encounter historical or cultural details that invite additional research, like the boat in verse 36. The factbook is the best starting point when studying themes, people, places, or events. I'll type boat and choose ships and boats from the dropdown. The entry includes a summary article, helpful visuals, key passages, biblical words, and more. Click through the factbook's lenses to surface different resources. For example, the library lens will mine all your resources for any related articles, while the biblical lens will prioritize biblical passages that mention your search term and suggest questions to help you dig deeper. Let's click one of these questions to open one last tool, the Study Assistant. The Study Assistant allows you to essentially have a conversation with your library by summarizing answers from top articles within seconds. Notice that this answer includes the observation that boats are often used to demonstrate God's sovereignty and power. That prompts a follow-up question. What passages use boats in this way? We're reminded of Jesus walking on the water, of Jonah's flight from Tarshish, and of Noah's salvation from the flood. You can keep asking the Study Assistant questions as they arise, or click a reference or citation to explore the source material. Now you have a few tools that can help you get started. As you continue to use Logos, explore our free training content at support.logos.com. Welcome to Logos Bible Software. We can't wait to see how God uses it to help you grow in the light of the Bible.